Friday night, it's pizza night. Most of the time we make our own pizza with our homemade dough with a simple tomato sauce, some Italian mozzarella and some basil leaves. A delicious pizza margherita. But there aren't some other options when you don't have time to make your own pizza at home. And one of them is ordering from a local restaurant. But sometimes it arrives too late, it cools on the way, and sometimes it gets a little bit messy due to transport. Another option is buy a decent frozen pizza from the supermarket. It is less expensive, it takes around 15 minutes to prepare, and it will be super hot when it leaves the oven. But I know the big question comes, is there such a big difference in taste between a homemade pizza and a frozen pizza bought from the supermarket, that it is worth the effort to make a healthy pizza at home, or maybe it is better to buy a frozen pizza from the supermarket? And to answer this question, I went to the supermarket and bought a pizza Ristorante mozzarella from Dr. Oetker. First is first, let's make our homemade pizza with our homemade dough, with that simple tomato sauce, some basil leaves, and then let's prepare the frozen pizza, let's taste the both of them, and then let's judge. Let's start. To cook a wonderful pizza, you must first make an extraordinary dough from 600 milliliters of water or 2.5 cups, not cold, not warm. It is best to be at room temperature. A kilogram of all-purpose flour or 8 cups, 25 grams of fresh yeast and a pinch of salt. Stir the mixture with a wooden spoon until the dough just begins to come together. It will seem shaggy and dry, but don't worry. Turn out the dough onto a well-floured surface and work the gluten by kneading the dough. Use the heel of your hand to stretch out the dough and roll it back up, while the other hand acts like an anchor. Continue this for about 8 minutes until the dough becomes smooth and glossy. It should also feel tighter and elastic. Then divide the bulk of dough into individual portions. I recommend you make 5 balls about the size of a tennis ball. Ensure your dough balls are neatly shaped, then place them in a tray or container. Cover your balls with a kitchen towel. That sounded a little weird. And allow the dough to rise in a warm, dry area for 1 hour or until the dough has doubled in size. Place a pizza stone on your oven and turn the heat to its highest settings. Let it heat for at least an hour. I like to have pizza with garlic sauce. Just a simple garlic sauce made from garlic, extra virgin olive oil, salt and some basil leaves, and all of them crushed in a mortar. Please tell me in the comments below, what kind of sauce do you have when you are eating pizza? When it comes to ingredients, whole canned tomatoes are perfect. In a large bowl, crush the tomatoes by hand. This is the old school way they used to do it in Naples, and for good reason. If you put the tomatoes in a food processor, you end up with a depressingly smooth sauce that lacks texture. This is a pure, unadulterated tomato goodness. Never use buffalo mozzarella, as it is too milky and will make your pizza base very soggy. Once rested, remove the dough ball onto a well-floured surface. Gently stretch the pizza dough into roughly a 10-inch circle. Don't worry if it is not perfect uniform. If the pizza springs back or is too elastic, allow it to rest for an additional 5 minutes. The edges of the dough can be slightly thicker, but make sure the center of the dough is thin. Using a large wooden spoon, add the tomato sauce onto the pizza dough, leaving a 1/2 inch border on all sides. Use the back of the spoon to spread it evenly and thinly. Sprinkle some salt on top. I like the dough to be crispy and the cheese to be melted, but not burnt, so I'll gently slide the pizza from the peel onto the heated baking stone, and I will bake it for 5 minutes. After, I will add 1/2 of mozzarella, distributing it evenly over the entire pizza,
along with the basil leaves, and I will leave it to bake for another 5 minutes. But before, I will turn around the pizza for a more uniform bake. In the end, I will finish with some extra virgin olive oil for a more authentic taste.
For me, pizza means the raw taste of tomato sauce, the melted mozzarella, the basil leaves on top, and all of these ingredients, all of them, must be highlighted by a well-raised, crispy crust, a unique flavor and texture from its bread flour, with large bubbles,
and with a crust that is lightly crispy on the outside, yet soft and pliable enough to fold the slices in half.
It is very good, and now let's continue by cooking the frozen pizza.
The cooking instructions tell us to put it in the preheated oven at 200 degrees Celsius with the fan on for 15 minutes. This pizza ristorante has a long list of ingredients such as wheat flour, nianchin, blend of mozzarella and Edam cheese, tomato puree, sherry tomatoes, wraps with oil, water, yeast, basil, salt, sugar, spinach, parsley, garlic, modified potato starch, emulsifier A471, hydrolyzed vegetable protein, I don't know what is that, pepper, maltodextrin, cayenne pepper, lemon juice, caramel, dextrose, pepper extract, a lot. I'll turn it over because I don't want to burn it, but I want to bake it evenly on all sides.
Now I'm going to taste Pizza Ristorante from Dr. Oetker. I trust the doctors. It says here, richer topping, crispier base, delicious taste. Richer topping, it's a mozzarella pizza, it has plenty of mozzarella. Agree? I can feel so much the tomato sauce. And this something basil stuff, I don't like it. They should put some basil leaves, simple and efficient. Crispier base, it has small bubbles, so it's thinner, denser and crispier, but I like to be a little bit thick with large bubbles, slightly crispy on the outside and soft on the inside. Delicious taste. Honestly, I think frozen pizzas have their time and their place, and for the modern family, frozen pizza is like manna from heaven. It's easy and fast to make, it's cheap, and it takes practically no preparation or planning for it. Please tell me in the comments below which one you like best. And if you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Until next time, I wish you all the best. You take care. Have a delicious day. Bye.